It's still too hot and dangerous to get to much of the crash site, so instead, the families of 30 missing people have been told their loved ones are most likely dead. With 20 bodies already recovered, it takes the presumed death toll from Saturday's train crash to 50.
Oui, t'inquiète pas pour moi, ok? Oh mon Dieu! Oh mon Dieu! Oh my God! Oh my God!
Unmanned and pulling dozens of tankers of oil, the runaway train built up speed over 7 miles before derailing in a town centre in Quebec. Hello. Arriving at the scene of the disaster for the first time, the head of the US railway company, which owns the train, was greeted with jeers.
Ton nom c'est Burkhardt!
Edward Burkhardt's response has been criticised by some officials as deplorable and unacceptable. He's blaming the driver, saying he didn't set the brakes properly before leaving the train.
We think he applied some handbrakes. The question is, did he apply enough of them? He's told us that he applied 11 handbrakes, and our general feeling is that that's not now, that that is not true. Initially, we took him at his word.
According to local media in Canada, Edward Burkhardt was questioned by police after he spoke to the media, detectives wanting to talk to him about his claims. With the crash the focus of a major police investigation, this town is being treated as a crime scene. 60 million's been set aside for helping victims and rebuilding. Claire Fallon, Sky News.